Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, good whatever time of day it may be for you, ladies and gentlemen. I am the Layback Gamer, and we are back with some more Civilization 4 Rise of Mankind edition. And by edition, I mean mods, because it is a mod. It is not something you can just buy from the game. You can actually you can get this for free, so you don't even need to. You don't have to spend a penny if you already own Civ 4. We are back, and we're here to try to see if we can discover one important thing that's going to influence, basically, what we go for next. And that is, if we have any iron on this island, I'm hoping we do, we could really use some iron. Iron's going to allow us to besiege the German Empire and try to rip them apart. I really... Oh, wow, Hanging Gardens is built this late. I thought this was built a while ago. I guess not. The one thing that I did take note of between the last episode and this episode is we're going to need sculpture. Which means, unfortunately, we had to get ritualism. Maybe he'll be willing to trade. Nope. He, as a matter of fact, is not willing to trade. Ah, good. You finished your trade, caravans. Excellent. Excellent. Now let's start getting... Let's start getting some research, because I really could use that right about now. Now, monarchy, I don't think is going to give me anything that I don't... That I can't build. That I can build, sorry. It is going to give me stuff that I can't build. And unfortunately, that's just not going to work for me. Congratulations on your founding of the Islamic religion. How many religions does that make? That is 3, 4, 5 religions. 5 religions out of how many? Oh, and a great general's died. 5 out of 10 religions. So, what does that tell me? Well, that tells me that somebody's got polytheism, ceremonial burial, monotheism, dualism, and likely meditation. I can't see them having a calendar. Which is where I hope to get a religion from, though I'm probably not going to. So, on the off chance of that, we sort of do have a bit of a backup strategy. That's going to be aesthetics. And we are going to research aesthetics because I could use aesthetics. I could use a good bit of aesthetics in my empire. It gives me access to the religious building. That allows me to pick essentially any religion that I wish. And I'll be honest, I'm not sure if we might go for now a very extremist religion, if we happen to get one. And the one that's basically, since we don't have any other religion in our borders, and I'm hoping that we don't ever, well, we are going to. It's inevitable when we start conquering cities. But I'm going to see if we can try to start up some inquisitions, which will be exciting. I've never used an inquisitor before, so it's going to be a new experience. Or I find the person who has researched, or not researched, but who has founded Christianity and take it from them, as well as the Holy City. And that's very likely to throw their entire empire into chaos. Because they're going to go, oh, they took the holy city from us. That's unacceptable. We have to take it back. And of course, we can't let that happen. They're not allowed to get that holy city back. That's ours to keep forever and ever. And speaking of keep forever and ever, I need to get a fishing boat over there so we may hold on to that. Or actually, 2 fishing boats. Alright, so start with that. Oh, and we'll need a settler soon. So I suppose after you're done that, you can get a settler. Because I would like to put this city up as quick as possible and start harvesting the Well, not harvest, but start getting this sheep. That way we can build the butchery and get some extra growth happening in our cities. Because we need big cities. Speaking of big cities, that's fortunately not too big. Well, not big enough where for now it's not going to make too much of a difference. Hey, Germans, can you stop gaining points? Oh, you're now going for priesthood. Okay, interesting. Could be a Kibi going that would require priesthood. Is he maybe. Could he possibly be trying to make his monarchy cheaper? I mean, this is a rather quick way to get to monarchy. And it would. I think it would make sense that he would try to go for this. And of course, we gotta build the treasury. Once we get monarchy. A great general is, but wow, there are civilizations just going at it. Oh yeah, speaking of civilizations really going at it. In my other the game that I pl the game of Civilization that I have going on in my free time, when I'm not doing homework or planning stuff for YouTube, the Iroquois, we have an Iroquois leader in our game, and he's conducting war very effectively. He's mad. He's taking. He alone has crippled at least three civilizations. And while I've done more than that, I've been able to just to say a number. I've been able to get. Oh, jeez, I've already lost count. I think six civilizations. I've destroyed two of them. No, I've destroyed three of them and capitulated three others. So I destroyed the Russian Empire, the Egyptian Empire, and the Arabian Empire. And I capitulated the Mayan Empire, which was a split off from the Egyptian Empire. And the Arabians were another split off from the Egyptian Empire. I capitulated the Incan Empire, and I just finished capitulating Gandhi, who, as we all know, is a giant threat, and I'm going to be arming him with nuclear missiles. I don't know if he actually does that in Civ 4. I'm going to pretend he does. Oh, I actually lied. This city is going to have conflicting borders here, or plots here and here, but this is a mountain. And mountain turfs do not matter to me. It does not matter. He's going to go up more points. He's just went. Past few turns, he's been going up a bunch of points. Ah, he is going after monarchy. I called that. I called that correct. Are you willing to give me anything? You still aren't. I get a feeling that's going to be. You're going to be doing that for a while. Let's see what you can research. Okay, so we're pretty much on the same boat with a lot of the. Well, we're not on the same boat with Tex. He's clearly got more Tex than I do. And I guess it sort of makes sense-ish in a way. I'm wondering if he managed to conquer someone. He might actually be going after ironworking. Which, if that's the case, he would need to get bronze working first. What else can you get with monarchy? Monarchy can lead into aristocracy, which leads into vassalage. That would make sense. Maybe he's going for code of laws. Ooh, actually, come to think of it, that would be really good. Yeah. Oh, but he doesn't have writing. So, a bit of a change of game plan. Let's do this. Then, where was I going after this? Oh, yeah. Aesthetics. I think we'll still go after aesthetics for now. Just as a backup plan in case we can't get to Code of Law before our German friends here can. I want to get iron working first so that I can check for iron. And once... when is the board popping? 75 turns. Excellent. That's going to take us a long time. Let's see. These two settlements could use mines. Or not settlements, but these two hills could use some mines. Oh, speaking of what you could use, you can go back to this. I forgot to switch you, sorry. Deathfang should grow. I might make the next tile one of these so it could get some extra production. Or when is it going to pop the borders? 100. Okay, so it's likely to grow 1.5 times. Oh, that's not good. Oh, why are you suddenly unhappy? We are now a million soul empire, which is great. Oh, the shaft mines are coming into effect. Ooh. Yeah, that's a problem. We gotta take that away, just move you to there. That's actually kind of better for us. Oh, this is really gonna suck when we adopt Republic. That's gonna be another 3 unhappiness. And this Ozutai is gonna be a little unhappy. Fortunately, all these other cities... now, this one can't really afford to handle it either. Alright, well... can you... yeah, you can handle growing a little bit more. And these two, of course, are just... they're fresh cities. They can definitely handle it. We have nothing good, but nothing bad. So... well, we have bad stuff, but we don't have anything... bad in the cities. And by that meaning, we do have some good stuff.
Multitude of rulers is not a good thing. Let there be one ruler, one king.
Oh yes, but I don't want that. That's going to... if we take a look at monarchy, that's going to create some instability, and I don't want that. I do not want that. So, we're okay with this. It would be better than what we currently have, but the Republic is going to give us +6. +6 to national stability, and +5 to local stability. And I don't know about moving into this. I'm definitely not going to become a fascist. I don't know if I want to become a communist, though. I mean... but my and it's 60% gold. That's a harsh one. That's a harsh pill to swallow, and I really don't want that. So we might actually stay as a republic all game long, just because the benefits of it in this scenario, in this game, happen to be better. Excuse me, apparently I'm getting tired already. It's only 10:30. Jeez, why am I tired? I shouldn't be tired. It's only 10:30. Ah. Just a bit of a drink and we're ready to continue. Well, I didn't stop. We're just going to continue going. I am ideally going to go for about an hour and split this into two segments. I don't know if I'm going to be able to stay awake that long, but we'll try. I will try. And that is music to my ears. Unfortunately, that's not going to work out for us. So shockingly, we can get iron working quicker than he can. Which is weird, because I'm not running with, I believe on Prince, neither you nor the AI gets it. The AI might get a tiny bit of some slight buffs. but nothing too. I don't think they're getting anything too major. So we're so far we're keeping up with at least the only AI we happen to know. And Deathbringer's now working on our new settler. Oh wait, there is actually a building I can build with Monarchy. I lied. I didn't realize that I had the experience to do this. So we could build that for 7 turns and then go back to research. And also queue up the National Treasury. And we keep on going. So another thing that I probably should have mentioned in the last video was wonders. Now, wonders got a bit of a change in, well, at least how they work in terms of a city. No, we are not. Wow, we are not the largest. That's okay though. You can only it, now you can build up to 4 national wonders per city instead of 2. Oh, that's unfortunate. Oh, that is super unfortunate.
What's the plan?
You need to get over here because we lost our lead mine. Hey. Why is that growing? Why are we growing again? I don't think I told you guys to grow again. Why? What changed? I actually can't tell. Oh well, we'll fix that in a moment. Momentarily. Oh, the shaft mine got destroyed. Okay, that's why they're growing again. That's why they're growing again. The shaft mine got knocked out. Oh no, the mine got entirely knocked out. Well, for 18 turns, these guys are going to stay happy, but unfortunately, that mine there is going to become a shaft mine, and it's going to make everybody else angry. Also, we lost our only source to lead, but I mean, I'm not complaining about that. I don't really care about lead at this point. It's not useful until much, much, much later on. Oh, back on the topic of wonders, I seem to be deviating a lot from other from topics that I start. Don't finish up. We can only build 4 great wonders or world wonders per city. So the wonders that we build here, we got to make sure we pick up correct, which is why I'm trying to save this from having a lot of national wonders. This can only be built in the capital. Well, if we go to ideally, we would have wanted this in the commerce city. But as you can see, it requires the palace, and that would require to move our capital here. Now, I don't quite like the idea of that. I don't want to move my palace all the way to Noxus Dragon. I'd prefer not to, as a matter of fact. So that just means this city lose out on 10% research. Also, I realize I forgot to set you to go back, but thankfully you've been able to grow at a good pace and should be able to start harvesting, or not harvesting, but working these ocean tiles, which is excellent because we get to keep that nice pocket of gold that city's making, as well as the production that comes off of it. All right, well, with Monarchy, we can now get roads. So I'm going to start paving roads around the countryside. Now, we're going to hopefully do this in the exact direction that I want, but I want this one. I think I'm going to have this one curved to here, then one that leads here, 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 and then to that city. One that comes up along the coastline, and the other one that comes up right here. That way we have two. This is a nice triangle of cities. And of course, this one's going to connect to here, to here. We're not going to have this one go all the way to here, but this one's going to snake around the mountain to here. And this city's going to be branching out to all the other cities. It's going to be a very centralized city. That's the game plan. Let's get this guy up here so we can get the farm built faster. Or at least quicker. Germany is still plucking away at monarchy. I think they may have slowed down a bit. And that's fine by me. I don't care that they slowed down. I kind of need them to slow down. Now we're almost at ironworking. Very nice. Let's hope we got some iron. Because otherwise we have to go try to find some. Or we steal it from the Germans. And for some reason we haven't built a military unit, and yet we managed to climb up in strength. So I'm guessing they lost something. Either that or they decided to delete it. Why? I do not know. Or it could be that they're putting their... The AI is thinking and using trade caravans like I am. That would be nice if the AI was able to put two and two together. Are you kidding? I'm not just going to hand you that for free. He's thinking. He's going, hang on a minute. Oh, wow, that's been built rather quickly. I don't know, actually. Where or how I can build that. But German AI is going, hang on a minute. I want to get code of laws. But I don't have writing. Wait. Hey, the Draconic American Empire, even though it does not say Draconic there, they have access to it. Let me just go ask to if I can take this technology from them. What? What are you talking about? I want that technology to beat you to something.
You should hammer your iron when it is broken.
Yes! We got iron! We got iron! Only one source, but I am happy with that! Oh, that is so wonderful. And now they're angry again. Why can't you guys ever be happy? Yes, I can see that it became unhappy. I am not blind, don't worry. I know you like to think, game, that I'm blind some days, but I promise you, I am not blind. And now we strive for code of laws. With any luck, we will be able to beat the German Empire to it. And we can go ahead and go at 80% research. Oh, they've stopped harvesting that. Okay, fair enough. Fire rages throughout the German city of Hamburg. Well, that's unfortunate. Sorry, friend. Nothing I can do about that. Actually, we really should be trying to go for the calendar next. Although the problem is that's going to reveal another religion. And where would I like to go next? Let's put up a mine there. We're not going to be able to use it. But as long as it's in our borders, we should be able to try to mine something for it. We might be able to mine something out of it. Alright. I don't care about that at the moment. We need to get this iron in our grasp. Also, I would like to ask, why did you move... Oh, I did. I told them to do that. Hang on a second. Now they can go back to it because they got some extra happiness. and we can build a meeting hall, which is only going well as long if we have alcohol. I don't think I've ever seen alcohol. I should probably provide some context. I don't think I've ever seen alcohol in this game. I've seen some wine, I have seen beer, I see that barbarian galley, who apparently is a bit weakened. He must have fought off one of the Germans, and then managed to get away with his life. Alright, I want a mine immediately there, a mine there. I'm kind of disapproving of the lack of security in this city. We should probably... strive. Oh, we can get an axeman. I can get it. Oh yeah, I do have the ability to get axeman. Whoops, my bad. I forgot about that. And hope that it's not here to drop off a bunch of marauders to try to pillage my land. He's going around me. How dare you? Listen, you do not get to ignore me. Come fight my galley. Or go into something that's going... How dare you? Get back here. And dead. Just the way I like it. Ooh, Bismarck has gotten monarchy. And now he's going after... So he's going after ironworking instead. Let's put you back into the city for now. I've got an idea. Since we don't have to worry about him beating us to code of laws, we can load an explorer up, and because we'll now have a ship to be able to get to the other side of the ocean safely, well, in a turn or two. Ojutai's borders has just expanded. Unfortunately, not revealing anything that I don't already know. But thank you, nevertheless. Alright, send you to here. Send you to here. And I'm going to need to produce another galley after we get Code of Laws. And with Code of Laws, we can get some courthouses. Little bit of maintenance discounting throughout our soon-to-be six cities. I'll be happy with that. Alright, have him rest up there. Have this guy head all the way down to here. And unfortunately, we are losing 3 gold per turn. That's okay, though. Or will the treasury be able to recover all that? It's not going... Well, it'll recover about half of it. I do want to get to Code of Laws first. Then afterwards, we'll need democracy as a stability purpose. And once we have that, we will also adopt Senate. We will be the Senate. Ah, perfect. Now you can defend our city. And just continue to pass. Did somebody beat me to code of laws? Ooh, somebody out there might actually... They might be a threat to me. I'll have to keep my eyes out. Because somebody's clearly been doing a lot of research. A lot of work to try and get ahead. Alright, board up into this transport. Fortunately, they shouldn't be able to die while inside a city. And I just need to wait 15 turns. Okay, I can wait 15 turns. We can wait 15 turns, that's no problem. Got a galley. Got a rogue galley. Alright, send, and this one's at full health. So let's send the fleet out. They should be more than a match for him. We have a card path there? We do have a card path there. We'll do that. And they're going along the coastline there. Alright, let's pincer him in. Oh, we got a well-trained galley with this. Nice. Now, unfortunately, we do have a slight combat disadvantage. Let's hope that he can't kill that. This one galley cannot take out two galleys. Yeah, that one I saw coming. Yes, he did manage to get some dents off, and that's going to be more than enough for that to happen. Alright, you boys can go back home. We'll take a slight 5-turn detour, train up two more galleys. That's going to replace both the one that we're going to send over to Bismarck and the one that we lost. Oop, and apparently somebody died. There must be a lot of revolutions going on. Oh, nice, this one's even starting with a promotion. Sweet. Okay, so you've got one there. You're going to lose one. So we'll send you down to there. Oh, yes, and then I have to train up another two more. I almost forgot about that. We need two more for down here. Alright, where are we going with this next? Well, I'm going to start... Ooh, nice, card path. Let's quickly make that path so we can get access to iron. Because I want iron. I really want some iron. And a great engineer has been born in a faraway lands. And for some reason, we are now shrinking. Oh, you guys are so petty. You guys are absolutely petty. Some improvements are making us unhappy. You should stop making improvements. You should stop making our lives better. Because we do not like that. Thank you. All right, and this is going to add some extra production in addition to discounting the movement speed of our troops. But now we can. Okay, for some reason we still don't have access to this. Well, that's why we don't have a cart path there. Oh, that's an undersight. We gotta make a cart path. Get a cart path. We need that cart path very quickly. Well, not very quickly, but we do need it as fast as we can get it. All right, how are we doing for time? Well, I'm well over the first episode. And he's here. Oh, excellent! The city's now expanded. No, I wanted you to go here. And then wait a turn because we will need that extra turn in order to get into Bismarck's territory. Oh, this is nice. We're going to actually see what's in his land. He himself is getting bronze working. And look at that. We are now free to explore his mighty kingdom and vomit this out, and he already has iron. All right, so there's the city of Munich. Is this going to give me some extra espionage to him because I did discover where he is? I don't know. He's got copper and iron. Munich is going to have to be a staging ground for our invasion, but it's going to be difficult to take his cities out by the looks of it. There's Berlin. It's not too far away from the cap from where he is. That's good. That is good. We will have to send some galleys over here. It's likely that this one galley is going to be doing all the work. Oh, actually, that's a lie. We can promote a couple of our galleys to have navigation and get to him that way. Thankfully, Bismarck doesn't quite have it in him to put that together. But that also will influence. We gain access to iron, which is great. So we're going to get code of law, democracy, and do a bit of a complete 180 on our tech change. We need siege warfare and smithing. Smithing so we can get swordsmen to attack his cities, siege warfare for catapults, and so we can get to smithing. And the high walls and the siege workshop will be nice. By then, we should have all of our cities established on this island and hopefully be ready to start taking out the Germans. Now, another technology I would like to get is the ability to capitulate the German Empire, but I don't think that's going to happen. You know, actually, we can have both of these guy. We can have the pathway from here go 1, 2, and meet on the lead. We can have both of these meet here and then enter into the city. Oh, if you think you're angry now, just wait until we switch civics. Oh boy, they're gonna be so mad. The population is gonna be absolutely furious with us. Now, fortunately, he does only really have. He only seems to have access. He only has archers and spearmen. And I do know that's a testament to the fact that he doesn't have bronze or iron working, which he is going to have to get writing in order to get iron working. Oh no, he doesn't. Actually, he can just get the technology right now. Maybe he's saving up the technology in order to try and kill me. But this looks like the end of his small island here. Ooh. Yeah, that's That's simply not going to... This'll do for our conquest. We could take this entire area and turn it into our colony. We just have to figure out if this is his only source of iron. Because if it is, we might try to... We'll have to land a couple of troops over here to secure it. And make sure that he cannot build swordsmen. And he has whales. He has some whales in his border. Okay, I'm happy with that. This is going to make a fine conquest. Absolutely fine one. That's ocean, unfortunately. Alright, well, let's have you return to this coastline, and we'll get our battle plans ready, since he's been very kind enough in order to let me explore his entire land. Yes, that could be a cottage, but... Yeah, we're going to make a cottage first. So, let's get that. Alright, we'll be able to make a successful war against the German kingdom. And hopefully overtake them. We can't trade him bronze working. He doesn't want that, and he doesn't want to trade us anything else. Well, you're just a giant pain. I really hope that our religion doesn't spread over here. Because that's going to make our people a little bit angry. Oh, no, 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 no. You are not going to kill my stuff today. Alright, so he actually has a decent land. He's got whales, which is one of the rarer resources in one of these games. So we can capture that, and I'll have access to that. And of course, our lovely Colossus is going to make this absolutely beautiful and wonderful to use. I don't think that we have any... We can't trade... Yeah, we're not connected to his trade network, unfortunately. But if we did capture Munich, we would be. Though, I'll be honest, I kind of want to completely kill him. Which is going to take a bit of work. We can do it. We just have to be very strategic about about what cities we go after. There he's going after our transports. We should be getting a defensive bonus, and it is enough to sink his ship. And we're getting 3 combat strength. It's back into the city. Good job. Okay, and you can just auto-explore around here. Just continuously update this quadrant. We'll have you wait. We need to make sure that we can make this jump safely into friendly territory. I don't feel like risking that. He's now going for iron working. Okay. Now, he does have monarchy, but I don't think his units are well trained enough in order to have... In order to hit the meeting hall. Which means he might attempt to use military tradition. And that's something we should get as well. Actually, this is something we get before we get siege warfare. What could he want? The only thing I can go into is siege warfare, which we want machinery after that. Right, at the moment. So, I don't quite understand the AI's thinking in... Well, I do understand it. He does want to get iron working as a defensive technology, but... What else? Okay, so, seeing what he can research, War Galley might be useful for him. Matter of fact, it might be extremely useful for him, and we might have a problem if he goes for it first. We'll have to start our garrison of troops here. I'm thinking an army of four catapults and four swordsmen, backed up by an axeman and a pikeman for each city. That should be enough to hold these cities off from counterattacks. We'll have to go Munich, Berlin, and that will take away his strategic resources, with the exception of obsidian. Keep a large garrison here and only pull troops out when we've defeated these cities. So we would then go to Hamburg, then up to Collagen, and then Frankfurt. Alright. Sounds like we got our plan of attack. Now we just have to make sure that we do it in a
quick manner.
Bring about
the rule of righteousness in the land so that the strong should not harm the weak.
Yeah, the reason why we want this is, yes, the plus unhappiness in eight largest cities is going to suck. We do get extra food from trade routes, and we do get some extra stability for local and national, but the main reason for this is that nice little textile line at the very bottom. We can spend gold to hurry up production in the city, and we are now mighty Taoists. Now, unfortunately, because of our civics choice, we can't convert. Or can we? Nope, we can't convert, because we cannot convert, unfortunately. But yes, we did get an alchemist, which is the name of the Taoist missionary, and we'll send it right to the capital. It's not going to provide any happiness until we research the ability to build temples, which I think comes with priesthood. So if Bismarck's going to be nice enough to give us those technologies, which I don't think he's going to be. Yeah, he's not going to be nice enough to do that. He wants ironworking. He wants writing. We would be fools to give him that. Especially since I want to kill him. We don't want a capitulation. There will be no mercy in this war. We are going for a full kill here and now. I don't have enough time to prep to build an army at the moment, especially since, well, I suppose I could, but it would go really poorly against city defenses. Actually, where can I view the top five cities? Oh, probably under here. So, wow, one city has built all of this. I could mistake in the okay, that makes sense. I kind of figured the Germans did. I didn't say it aloud, but I kind of did figure that the Germans built the Chichen Itza, or the Chicken Pizza, based on the sole fact that their cities had 55% fortification. And I could really use those benefits. So we'll need to take that from them. Fortunately, they're going to be very polite and just give it to us. Now, that's not going to do anything right now, but when we do eventually adopt a religion... Oh, speaking of which, I want that. Happiness is unfortunately a factor here. Now, if we do that and get that courthouse quickly... I need a religion civic. I really need a religion civic. So that's actually going to halt my progress temporarily so that we can pick up mysticism and get a civic. Military training, siege warfare, smithing. Then we get currency and machinery. Excellent. We have a lot to do, and I don't know how much time we have to do it. Now, another great general has been born a faraway distance. I don't mind that the city is starving, by the way. I know that that might sound a little harsh, but I don't mind that it's starving for the solely for the fact that it's going to decrease this. And then when we put it back after 25 turns, it's going to go back to increasing it. Maybe no, actually, might not be a good time to adopt democracy. We will need that. Because democracy, if we go ahead and go to civics, or no, I mean republic, is going to give us plus 3 unhappiness in the 8 largest cities. Which could really cripple us. The Senate's only going to give us 1, but gives us plus 1 happiness from an agora. And I'm going to be honest, I kind of think I really did screw up a bit in allowing that city to grow so large without gaining any access to any other resources. The gems can make us some happiness with a jeweler. Anything else that can get us... No, he doesn't have anything that's going to give us happiness. The whales can, but that's later. The monument can as well. And same with profits. So I suppose I'm going to do a lot of my adopting, a lot of my civics changes when we get, when I can adopt my religion. For now, are there any cities, no cities are in danger of revolting. That is good. Do I want you? Oh, now that I kind of think about it, I don't think I actually want you to continue. Now that I think about it a little more. Good, Taoism is spreading in our lands. Just do not spread to the Germans. I don't think we can. I don't think we can spread to the Germans because we... Well, we might. I don't know. I do not know. The last game that I was playing in, I did not spread to any AI. Actually, originally, I did not... Well, I did end up spreading to the Egyptians. And originally, I was not going to take up a religion that game. But after seeing how good of a job the Egyptians did at spreading around Christianity, I said, you know what? We're going to adopt it. But first, we need to kill you. Because I don't need my people getting angry. I don't need war weariness from fighting people in the same faith. That is just not a good idea. Especially since the unhappiness could have been crippling. Thankfully, it was not. Very well. And of course, we need a new name for this city. It can't be Washington. It shouldn't be Washington. So therefore, I have no choice. Well, actually, I have all the choice in the world. It's a random choice to name it Swift War Kite. I don't know if we can fit the space in there. Oh, we can. How nice. And you want a swordsman for defense. But I don't want you to get a swordsman. I want you to get a fisherman's hut. Then a lighthouse. Then some walls. And... And this... Nope, not that. I don't want the scribes just yet. That, and that. Perfect. What do you need? You'd move into that city. Yes. And then we can afford to send... probably all 4 of them might be necessary, come to think of it. Decrease that so that we're at minus 4 per turn. That's gonna It's not destabilizing our empire. We're still in a good spot. And of course, we need one more city here, and we'll be good. Once we get the city sort of all set up and ready to go, everything should be all right. Oh, I forgot to build a road there. Oh, well. At least the city is growing nicely. Speaking of which, almost forgot to do that. How silly of me. So, nope, you're now harvesting that. That'll allow you to grow much, much quicker. Not as much commerce, though, which is a unfortunate thing. Alexander Graham Bell. Well, I think you're a little early, my friend. You're not supposed to be born until much, much later. You're supposed to... I believe you invent the telephone. So, come back when we're able to get the telephone. And we are now here. This city is going to be very close to finishing up our fisherman's hut, which is going to give these tiles some extra commerce. Oh, how sad. Somebody died in battle. Afterwards, I want you and you to start waiting turns, and then you can fortify up. Because we need you to put everything you got into that lighthouse, and then go after the last one goes after the walls. Because we need some culture gain. Need to push our borders out and see where it takes us. Oh, and both of you get into the city. How close are you to growing? 9 turns and we can get that shrimp. Excellent. Let's hope that this courthouse really makes a difference. Oh, and after the courthouse, we can even get a treasury, too. So, get the treasury. That'll allow us to get more gold per turn. And of course, I need a lot of gold per turn. And I suppose we can just continue to route you to there. That would be a good day. That's a good idea. Let's keep doing that. How soon can you have that out? 2 turns, that's okay. And have you guys wait one more. Alright, so I have a question. Does the bat... Not the bazaar, the butchery, and it does not. Okay, butchery does not give us any more happiness. That's not going to give us any more happiness. And... sadly, this isn't going to give... If anything, it's going to give us a lot of unhealthiness. But we're good... Well, actually, we are not good on health. Oh my... Oh my, we may have came close to driving our empire into the ground. Fortunately, we did catch it on time. So, in addition to fixing these 3 angry citizens, which, I'll be honest, this is where slavery would have came into play and it would have been nice to have it. But we're not going to whip people. I don't need them to get mad at me. It is absolutely a poor idea. Borders of Deathfang are going to grow. Oh, I can't actually send him out there because he's going to die if I do that. Oh, I can't even send him out there anyways. He can't explore. And we reveal open waters. And we can now start harvesting that. Goes for 1 less commerce than what we would be harvesting there, but in turn, we are getting more food, and that is important. +2 food, please. You've built to there, so now head over here, and we need to put down another path. And we are almost at the, well, I am at the end of this recording session, but we will finish. Like always, we will take one more turn. Okay, that was a little too short. Let's take one more turn. Need something exciting to happen.
What's the plan?
Okay, fine. We will go until we research democracy. There we go. That's a better choice. And our courthouse has effectively made us balance at 75%. The jeweler finishing up there, in combination with the treasury, should allow us to finish up to, or not finish up, but go into the positive for gold per turn. I would have you build a cottage, but I actually need you to continue to route this way. And that is a really good sword, not swordsman, spearman. I had to think of a name for a second there. All right, since we are going to rapidly add five cities into our nation, when we do start our military planning, after we get all the technologies that we need, we're going to have to reduce our gold per turn by a lot and make sure that we bring some alchemists slash missionaries with us. Because we'll have to make these guys happier somehow, and with a cult in the city, that should do it. I'll be honest, I'm surprised this really hasn't gone up too much. Well, it did help a bit. So head back to here and get another road. He's about to get iron working. Has he actually got any axemen? He's not. I don't think he suspects a thing at the moment. If you continue our research, we're going for democracy. It's looking like we're trying to be a very respectable nation, and unfortunately, there's a pesky barbarian galley that has somehow managed to sneak up on us. Well, we can't have him here, so away with you, please. I don't think you heard me loud enough, game. I said, away with you. That's what I like to see. Good show. Oh, and he got a lot of experience from that too. He can definitely get the navigational boost. So, oh my goodness, we lost a lot of influence to that one gap from that one galley. I hope that isn't. No, that's not contributing to anything else. Okay, that's good. That is good. That is very good. Didn't I have a workbook down here? No, it doesn't really matter. The city isn't going to. Oh, where are you getting this culture from? Oh, there's a religion in the city. That's why you're getting the culture. Oh, yes, I forgot. That's another excellent way. Also, you need to get into a city. And stop costing me gold per turn for keeping you outside a city.
Yes.
How much production do I have put into that? Okay, I'd be wasting a little bit, but I get. Okay, we can wait for a jeweler. I can do that. We can wait for a jeweler. Next one's got to be here. Then the last one's going to be there. Two more turns before democracy. And he is going after writing, so I think he's going to try to get code of laws. Okay, so this is an interesting choice by the AI. He wants to get writing, which is going to unlock alphabet, mathematics, currency, and, well, he already has monarchy. But it's going to get him a lot, and it's also going to be the key to get, well, he can get code of laws from that and city planning. So I'm wondering if he's planning on getting city planning. It would be a good choice of technology for us to go after we've assimilated the Germans into our empire, but I do like the idea of having currency and getting markets. We're not going to be able to use those, at least I don't know. We haven't discovered naturopathy yet. Have you rest up? and we'll need a new galley to replace that other one. We'll just get him a new one. And then afterwards, I need to get our workers down to here so we can start to make this land by Swift Warkite a little bit more useful. Alright, let's go for a big... Oh, we can actually successfully research it next turn at 0% research and collect a nice bit of gold. I think we can go up to 75%. Yes, we can.
It has been said that democracy is the worst form of government, except all the others that have been tried.
And there's our Agora, which is going to give us +1 happiness with Senate, give us some extra military production, a bit of extra research, a tiny bit of extra culture, and I believe with some ports and trade routes, it's going to give us a little bit of everything. So I would be interested in that. However, this unfortunately gives us a lot of national instability per turn. Even still, I think that could be worth it. I mean, so far our empire, I have never had a game where our empire has been at risk to fall apart. So I think when we do this, we take Senate, we take Republic. Oh, goodness gracious, we're going to be in revolt for a long time. And we take Prophis, which is 12 turns of anarchy. I think I will have to live through. Okay, so I am making a bit of a change of plan. I was originally going to only stop here, but I am going to get Mysticism to get Prophis. And I will end our episode. I will end this in anarchy. What with our civilization being in anarchy. However, when you guys see me next, and you see how this is bad. Oh, thank you. You guys are awesome. You built a pasture for me. Yeah, I did not realize that this was getting that bad. This is definitely getting worse. Well, it's actually not that bad. Okay. They've been starving for long enough. This sounded so bad. Yeah, I think they've been starving for not long enough. We can go ahead and switch back to the... Oh, what have I done? My gosh. That sounded absolutely awful. Yeah, I think they've been starving for long enough. We can go ahead and give them more food. I mean, we have so much food around this place. We can give them some more food. So, the unhappiness was definitely a bad thing. Starvation also sort of contributed to that. Sadly, there's no way to make these guys any happier. Oh yeah, and then I also do have to adopt a religion, which I believe is going to take another few turns. So the next session that I do, I'm going to start up. Well, at least I'm going to start my recording with the civics all changed up and the religion all changed up. Just because it's going to be a lot of me just clicking the end turn button. It's not going to be very exciting. And I've now given myself the hiccups. Which unfortunately means Germany is going to get a... Possibly... I think it takes 4 turns for a religious civic. Or not religious civic, but a religious tech to change over. So they're going to be getting a 16 turn advantage up on me. I hope you use that well to get something that's going to... Oh, hold on a second. I just thought of something. I know, that might come as a shocker to some people, but I just thought of something. He could be getting right... Well, actually, never mind. That theory's out the window. I was going to say, he could be getting writing, in order to try to pursue feudalism. And that's going to give him long bowmen. Now, normally that's that. Now, in a normal game of Civilization, that's not actually bad, because by that point, you're going to be you have macemen, it has a strength of 6, and you can use trebuchets and catapults to weaken a city. However, this is sadly, also the AI doesn't know how to do ranged attacks. But this has plus 8 strength, and the best thing I'm going to have, while I am going to have swordsmen, I'm also going to have some catapults. Well, if he gets these established and really gets going on them inside these cities, if he has a large number of them, I'm not going to be able to stop him. All right, so where's that galley going? The galley's going to park itself outside. Ritual always means throwing away something, destroying our corn or wine upon the altar of our gods. And we're going to need that. Get the treasury, get the galley, get the happiness. You know, I should really just have all of my cities built these while it's still 50% less from folklore. Or at least start on it. Okay, so you go ahead and finish the construction of that monument. Okay, you need the monument first. Everyone needs monuments first. And come over here. Have these two galleys attempt to take that on. Oh, nice! I don't have to replace it! Score! This is going to be very, very helpful. Oh, just going to give it extra combat strength. Noxious will has grown to size 3. Excellent! You can now harvest more tiles. You can go back up to 75% research. Once the monument finishes here, people will actually be happy enough to want to go back to work. Why am I not going from there? That's even better than that other tile. Okay, this is good. This is good. I need to get one of you guys down to here and start improving upon some of this land. The city's growing in 12 turns. We'll have a workboat out in 8. Well, in 8 working turns. We're not going to be working for the entire time. You know, actually, while I'm here, I will also grab naturopathy, so we can check to see if we have any of these resources. Then this, back to there, back there, up here. We can grab the calendar too, then machinery. I feel like I might be missing something. We can grab some other stuff a bit later. Agricultural tools would be nice. We need feudalism in order to expand down here, but grabbing this technology would be great for the grocers, especially if we have any of these resources. So he's going to get writing the same time we get mythicism. And we'll be able to see what the German Empire is going for. Oh, you are so happy. You are so good to be game. Oh, that is a blessing right there. Thank you, game. And also, thank you for the monument here. That's going to make people even more motivated to work for us. I wonder if it's motivated enough that we can move back. Nope, not that motivated. I'm going to go ahead and pay them a small bribe. Of a lot of money. And actually, we're improving as an empire. See, we're coming together. We're bringing this back around. We got this. All right, pasture that immediately, then we'll route right to the sheep. So again, I know I said I was going to end this after we got democracy, and then after we get mythicism. But we're going to go from mythicism, and then naturopathy, and then I promise we will end there, just so that I can get the last monument out.
Nature herself has imprinted on the minds of all the idea of God.
Hemp and mysticism, do we have any of that? We do not. Tobacco. You actually have hemp. That's good. That's okay. I will take that. Now, clearly he hasn't gone for fermentation just yet, so that's probably a telltale sign that he doesn't have anything that requires for... He doesn't have anything that requires an apple orchard or a lemon or a olive orchard. Yes, that was proper English. I English very goodly today, gentlemen and ladies. I know that wasn't... He's going mathematics! We don't need to see that. It's loud. It's a bit annoying, too. So he's going mathematics. That's why he needed that. I imagine he might try to go for the calendar. Or he could be going for siege warfare. I don't think he's going to go after construction. I genuinely do not believe that's his path of choice. I think he might be trying to find a religion. That might be on his mind, so it's going to be mathematics and the calendar. Now, if we hear another religion pop up, we know it's going to be the calendar. Not many people are going to have philosophy. It could be aesthetics, though. So I think his AI is going to tell him, oh no, wait, this has been built? Hold the phone, this has been built already. So somebody must have rushed right to the calendar. So somebody already has this. Could it be that meditation didn't get discovered? Let's see here. 1, 2, 3. How many religions are left? 3, 4. There's 4. So meditation might not have actually been discovered. Unless... Let's just go in here for a second. No, this requires the calendar, and I believe this has been built somewhere. Let me pull up those charts again. Nope, somebody has built this. Somebody has actually built this somewhere. So, the calendar, that means meditation hasn't been taken up yet. Which almost makes me think that the German Empire might actually be going for siege weaponry, and then eventually smithing. Ooh, well played, Germans. Well played. That's gonna suck for us, though. Alright, we can go up to 80%, because we are making a lot of gold per turn now. We are now flat as a nation. Alright. Hey, we got some spice plants. Nice. As is the gardener, such is the garden. Give us a healer's hut. Leads to fermentation wells, gives us bananas, spices, lemons, olives, and apples. We didn't get anything else in this territory, though. Okay, we don't actually need that. So we can go ahead and put you back to there. And then go for research. Good, they're calming down again. Happiness is not as big of an issue anymore. Let's see what they've got over here. So they don't have any... Oh, the Native Americans has been killed off. Lovely. So they don't have any other resources over here. Which means if we can c- connect up to some spices. We get a happiness, some extra gold. Maybe it might be worth it to put the city there. That way we get this as well. Because that's a decent grow tile. Although I might just be happy here. No, we're going to move over. We'll already have... This isn't going to give us too much. And having one spice is all we really, really need. So, it's going to be a race for us to get to see who can get the best army out. And he has a lot of technologies. However, we have a lot of advanced technologies. And with plans to get even more advanced. So, as our final act for this, we're going to revolt to some new civics. Thank you everybody for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Hit that subscribe button if you really enjoyed. This might be loud. Don't forget to share this video or any of my other videos to anybody who you think will enjoy my content. Next time when you come back, we're going to be a Taoist nation, and we will have all four of these civics completely integrated and adopted. Until next time, take it easy.